सो हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 247। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड गाइस इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम मोर क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द पीआईबी न्यूज व्हिच आर रेलेवेंट फॉर द ईएसआई सेक्शन ऑफ आरबीआई ग्रेड बी एंड नाबार्ड। एंड गाइस ड्यू टू सम ऑफ द कोविड रेस्ट्रिक्शंस आई वॉज नॉट एबल टू रिकॉर्ड दिस वीडियो ऑन द स्क्रीन, बट येस सून आई विल बी बैक ऑन द स्क्रीन, मे बी टुमारो आई विल बी एबल to record the video on the screen. All right, so let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon, and also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions. Right, so let's begin with the very first question, which says TRIFED, which is under the Ministry of Tribal Affairs. Now who is the Minister of Tribal Affairs? It's Mr. Arjun Munda. Arjun Munda is the Minister of Tribal Affairs and his Lok Sabha constituency is Khunti, which is of course in Jharkhand. So this ministry and TRIFED has launched Sankalp Se Siddhi, which is a village and digital connect drive, which was started from 1st of April 2021. The question is, which of the following is are not the objectives of this initiatives of this tribe? Okay, so let's discuss about this. So this Sankalp Se Siddhi has been launched by TRIFED. Remember this. Which organization has launched this? It is TRIFED, which has launched this initiative, which is known as Sankalp Se Siddhi. And of course, TRIFED works under the Ministry of Tribal Affairs. Now, this has been launched to activate the Vandhan Vikas Kendra in the visited villages. So there will be a team that will visit the villages, and in those villages, the Vandhan Vikas Kendras will be activated by those teams. All right. And it will, guys, be a 100 days drive, and total teams will be how much? 150 teams will be engaged, will be involved to implement this initiative, and total 1,500 villages will be covered under this initiative. And there are some of more objectives of this initiative, like the team will also identify the locations and shortlist some of the potential Vandhan Vikas Kendras which can be converted into the Trifood or the Sfurti clusters. And I hope you all remember what is this Trifood and Sfurti. So we have discussed earlier guys also that the Trifood basically are the parks which are nothing but the food processing centers. Ye jo Trifood hai ye kya hai? Ye ek initiative tha Ministry of Tribal Affairs ka. These are the food processing centers located at various locations, right? And what about Sfurti? It is basically a scheme of fund for regeneration of traditional industries which was launched to enable the traditional industries to be more productive and profitable. जो हमारी ट्रेडिशनल इंडस्ट्रीज है उनको प्रोडक्टिव और प्रॉफिटेबल बनाने के लिए दिस स्कीम ऑफ फंड फॉर रीजनरेशन ऑफ ट्रेडिशनल इंडस्ट्रीज वाज लॉन्च, राइट? एंड सम ऑफ द पोटेंशियल बंधन विकास केंद्रास विल बी आइडेंटिफाइड विच विल बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू द स्फूर्ति एंड ट्राइफूड क्लस्टर्स, राइट? एंड अदर देन दिस दे विल द टीम विल ऑल्सो आइडेंटिफाई द ट्राइबल आर्टिसंस एंड अदर ग्रुप्स एंड एम्पैनल देम एज द सप्लायर्स एंड देयर इज द टारगेट ऑफ ₹200 करोड़ सेल्स, 200 करोड़ की सेल का टारगेट है ड्यूरिंग द नेक्स्ट 12 मंथ्स अंडर दिस इनिशिएटिव व्हिच इज नोन एज संकल्प से सिद्धि, ऑलराइट? सो आई होप दिस न्यूज इज क्लियर एंड नाउ आई होप यू कैन इजीली आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन। क्वेश्चन इज व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज आर नॉट द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ द ड्राइव। सो टू एक्टिवेट द वंदन विकास केंद्रास इन द विजिटेड विलेजेस, यस इट इज वन ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्टिव। टू सुपरवाइज द इंप्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ द वेरियस प्रोग्राम्स एंड इनिशिएटिव्स, दिस इज नॉट द ऑब्जेक्टिव गाइस, ऐसा कुछ भी मेंशन नहीं किया गया है बाय द TRIFED। To establish clusters as Trifood and Sfurti units as the larger enterprises, yes, this is one of the objectives. Some of the potential Vandhan Vikas Kendras will be identified and they will be converted into Sfurti and the Trifood clusters. And to provide opportunities for distance and digital learning to the tribal children. No, this is not one of the objectives. This has not been mentioned by the Ministry of Tribal Affairs. So we have to identify which of the following is are not. So second and fourth guys should be the correct answer. So option D. 2 and 4 will be the correct answer. So I hope guys this question is clear, and now let's move ahead to question number 2. So question number 2 guys is about the integrated health information platform which was recently launched by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, which is of course headed by Dr. Harshvardhan, and Dr. Harshvardhan's Lok Sabha constituency is Chandni Chowk, which is of course in New Delhi. Okay, so the question is, which of the following is not one of the key features of this new system which is known as integrated health information platform? So guys, as the name suggests, it is a platform which will provide all the health related information in an integrated manner. Okay, and it has replaced the earlier version which is known as Integrated Disease Surveillance Program. Okay, so let's discuss about this news. So the news is that the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has launched this integrated health information platform, replacing the earlier integrated disease surveillance program. Now, what will it do? It will provide accurate, reliable and timely information about the Indian health system. India ka health related jo bhi data hai, jo bhi information hai, usko accurate manner mein, reliable manner mein aur timely information provide karai jayegi through this platform, which is known as integrated health information platform. All right. And it will be, of course, in sync with the government's national digital health mission, which was announced by Prime Minister last year. Now, guys, these are some of the key features of this newly launched system. It will be the world's biggest platform that will provide information related to the health of the citizens. Then it will track 33 diseases. 33 diseases ko ye track karega. And in the earlier system, there was a potential to track 18 diseases. Jo pehla wala system tha, usme 18 diseases ko track karne ki kshamta thi. But now this potential to track the diseases has been increased to 33 diseases. All right. It will ensure real-time data in digital mode through collecting data from the grassroots level, and it will be accessible at all levels. Har level pe accessible hoga, whether it is village level, state level or the center level. All right. Now it will be GIS enabled. Only then the information will be provided in the integrated manner. And other than this, role and hierarchy based feedback and alert mechanisms will be there. Geotagging of reporting health facilities will be there. There will be a scope for data integration with other health programs and advanced data modeling and analytical tools. So these are, guys, some of the basic features of this integrated health information platform, which will provide information regarding the Indian health system in an integrated manner. All right. So now let's come back to the question, which of the following is not one of the key features of the system? So it is termed as the world's biggest online disease surveillance platform. Yes, this is absolutely correct. It will track 33 diseases as compared to the earlier 18 diseases. This is also one of the features. It is accessible at all levels from villages, states and center. This is also correct. And it is GIS enabled. So guys, all of the above are the features. So this option should be like this. All of the above are the features. So option E, guys, here the correct answer. Option E, all the given options A, B, C, D are the features of this integrated health information platform. Alright, so option E here is the correct answer. I hope this question is clear. And now let's move ahead to question number 3. The Ministry of Port, Shipping and Waterways. Now you have to tell me who is the Minister of Port, Shipping and Waterways. Write down in the comments the name of Minister of Port, Shipping and Waterways. And if you know his Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha constituency, then that will be very good. So this ministry celebrated the 58th National Maritime Day on 5th April. What is not correct about the contribution of shipping in the country's economy? India ki jo economy hai ya India ki economy mein jo shipping ka contribution hai, uske baare mein hame batana hai. Okay, uske baare mein we have to identify the incorrect statement. All right, incorrect statement hame identify karni hai. So now let's talk about the news. What is the news about National Maritime Day? अगर हम बात करें, so National Maritime Day, guys, is celebrated every year on 5th of April. 5 April को मनाया जाता है हर साल. Now why it is celebrated on 5th of April? Because on this day in the year 1919, an Indian ship which was known as SS Loyalty, ये start हुआ था from Mumbai to London. Alright, Mumbai से London के लिए ये निकला था. It shipped from Mumbai to London in the year 1919 on this day, 5th of April. And you should remember the name of the ship, which is SS Loyalty. Alright. Now 2021 का theme was sustainable shipping beyond COVID-19. Remember the theme also, that's very important. Sustainable shipping beyond COVID-19. And it is celebrated, guys, to encourage the merchant shipping industry of India. When shipping contributes a lot to the country's economy. For example, at present, 90% of India's international trade in terms of volume and 77% in terms of value is moved through sea. 90% jo hamare desh ka trade hai in terms of volume and 77% in terms of value jo hai wo sea ke through hi travel karta hai. So that's a huge contribution of shipping sector in our economy. Okay. Now, since we are talking about Maritime Day, so let's talk about the Maritime India Vision 2030 also, which is nothing, guys, but a 10-year blueprint for the maritime sector of our country. And it was announced by Prime Minister of India at the Maritime India Summit 2021, which was held recently. Now, this Maritime India Vision 2030 will supersede the Sagarmala initiative, and it is aimed at boosting the waterways, giving a fillip to the shipbuilding industry in India, and also to encourage the cruise tourism in our country. Okay, so these are the some basic objectives of this Maritime India Vision 2030. Okay. Now, guys, there are some policy initiatives and projects under this Maritime Vision 2030, which we should know. Number one, there is a Maritime Development Fund to provide low cost and long term financing to the shipping sector. Then we have a Port Regulatory Authority for enabling oversight across all ports, enhancing the institutional coverage for ports and provide for structured growth. Then we have Eastern Waterways Connectivity Transport Grid Project, which will connect Bangladesh, Nepal, Bhutan and Myanmar. This is very, very important project because it will boost the international export, or you can say it will boost the international trade with the neighboring countries. Other than this, there will be a Riverine Development Fund, which will be for extending low cost, long term financing for the inland vessels, rationalization of port charges and promotion of water transport. So these are some of the projects and policy initiatives under the Maritime Vision 2030, which you should know. All right. So now let's come back to question number three. Question is, what is not correct about the contribution of shipping in the country's economy? So 90% of India's international trade in terms of volume is moved through sea. This is correct. And 77% of India's international trade in terms of value is moved through sea. This is also correct, guys. So dono correct hai, hame incorrect identify karne the. So neither one nor two should be the correct answer, option D. Hame incorrect identify karna tha. Aur dono hi correct hai, to neither one nor two is incorrect. Alright, so therefore the correct answer is what, option D. Alright. And now let's move ahead to question number four. The Atal Innovation Mission, Niti Aayog and CIPS announced collaboration to reinforce the innovation and entrepreneurship ecosystem in India. So the question is, CIPS stands for Atal Innovation Mission, Niti Aayog or CIPS, तीनों ने एक collaboration किया है ताकि innovation and entrepreneurship ecosystem को reinforce किया जा सके. So the question is, what is the full form of CIPS? So full form based question भी कई बार आ चुका है RBI में, so we should focus on the full forms also. एंड गाइज, अटल इनोवेशन मिशन जो है वो आए दिन कोई ना कोई नया इनिशिएटिव करता रहता है. हमने कई बार देखा है, 1,00,000 इनिशिएटिव वो अब तक कर चुका है, 1,00,000 कोलैबोरेशन कर चुका है. बट यस, वी कांट डू एनीथिंग, वी हैव टू रिमेंबर ऑल दीज इनिशिएटिव्स. ऑलराइट, सो अटल इनोवेशन मिशन जॉइन हैंड विद CIPS, नीति आयोग एंड CIPS. रिमेंबर स्टैंड फॉर सेंटर फॉर इनोवेशन इन पब्लिक सिस्टम. ओके, सेंटर फॉर इनोवेशन इन पब्लिक सिस्टम इज द फुल फॉर्म. And remember, this collaboration has been done to promote innovation and entrepreneurship, especially in the area of public systems, by leveraging the knowledge and experience of Atal Innovation Mission as well as the CIPS. Okay, so this is only the significant part about this news. And if we want to discuss the significance, so guys, these are some of the significance of this collaboration. Okay. These are not important for the exam, but these are just for the basic understanding ki ye cheeze kyun kahi gayi, jo ye collaboration hai ye kyun kiya gaya hai. So this will help startups to access and promote their innovations at the grassroots levels by synergizing the local administration. AIM and CIPS will together work to create awareness about the innovative products and solutions. There will be a series of e-exhibitions of Atal Innovation Mission. The partnership will help to promote programs launched by Atal Innovation Mission. Other than this, it will strengthen the Atal Innovation Mission Mentor of Change program, and it will also enable beneficiaries to harness CIPS research capacities. All right, so these are some of the significance, and these are, remember, just for the basic understanding. These are not important for the exam. Just remember, AIM has collaborated with Center for Innovations in Public System, which in short is CIPS, to promote innovation and entrepreneurship capacity in our country. All right. So I hope this question is clear, and now you can easily answer this question. CIPS stands for, guys, Center for Innovation in Public System. Option A will be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number five. Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare launched Madhu Kranti portal. And those who do not understand Hindi, it is this Madhu Kranti portal. Madhu means honey. Madhu means honey. Kranti means revolution. All right. क्रांति मीन्स वॉट रेवोल्यूशन, सो हनी रेवोल्यूशन पोर्टल विच इज वॉट मधु क्रांति पोर्टल एंड हनी कॉर्नर्स इनिशिएटिव ऑफ नाफेड. क्वेश्चन इज विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज द टेक्निकल एंड बैंकिंग पार्टनर ऑफ फॉर डेवलपमेंट ऑफ दिस डिजिटल प्लेटफॉर्म. सो गाइज दिस मधु क्रांति पोर्टल हैज बीन लॉन्च एंड इट इज एन इनिशिएटिव ऑफ नेशनल बी बोर्ड. नाउ वेयर दिस बोर्ड इज लोकेटेड, इट इज लोकेटेड इन न्यू दिल्ली ओनली. नेशनल बी बोर्ड इज हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन न्यू दिल्ली एंड इट इज एन इनिशिएटिव ऑफ नेशनल बी बोर्ड विच वर्क्स अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड फार्मर्स वेलफेयर विच इज करेंटली हेडेड बाय नरेंद्र सिंह तोमर, वी ऑल नो, एंड ही इज ऑल्सो द मिनिस्टर ऑफ फूड प्रोसेसिंग इंडस्ट्री. फूड प्रोसेसिंग इंडस्ट्री के मिनिस्टर भी है एंड ही इज ऑल्सो द मिनिस्टर ऑफ पंचायती राज. पंचायती राज के मिनिस्टर भी हैं ये, राइट. एंड इट हैज बीन लॉन्च अंडर द नेशनल बी कीपिंग एंड हनी मिशन. नाउ दिस पोर्टल, ये पोर्टल क्यों लॉन्च किया गया है? सो गाइज इट विल प्रोवाइड ऑल द इन्फॉर्मेशन रिलेटेड टू हनी प्रोडक्शन इन आवर कंट्री, द सोर्स ऑफ हनी, द क्वालिटी ऑफ हनी, द टाइप ऑफ हनी, ऑल द टाइप्स ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन रिलेटेड टू हनी एंड इट्स प्रोडक्शन विल बी प्रोवाइडेड थ्रू दिस पोर्टल विच इज नोन एज मधु क्रांति पोर्टल, राइट. And the technical and banking partner, guys, for this initiative will be Indian Bank. Indian Bank will be the technical and banking partner for this initiative. Now, it will lead, what are the benefits of this portal? It will lead to increase in the income of farmers, employment generation, and of course, the increase in exports of honey. It will help in checking the quality and source of adulteration of honey. And the system, guys, will also enable consumers or the public to know the source of honey and assurance. An assurance of the quality of the products will be provided through this portal. Alright. So I hope guys this question is also clear. The question is which of the following is the technical and banking partner? The correct answer is what? Option B, Indian Bank. Indian Bank will be the technical and banking partner for this initiative which is known as Madhu Kranti Portal. Alright. So guys that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care and God bless.